Hey, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, I'll explain how to import a CSV file into Plytix using the CSV Importer. If you haven't done so already, check out our video linked here that explains how to prepare your CSV datasheets so that you don't run into any problems during your import. To get to the CSV Importer, first click on Products, then Import. Here you'll be able to drag and drop a CSV file or click to browse the files on your computer. Remember that you can only import CSV files, so make sure to choose that option when downloading your file from Google Sheets, Excel, or any other spreadsheet tool that you use. Now, once you've chosen your file, you'll see a file preview of the data in your CSV sheet. The system will automatically detect the column separator, the text delimiter, and the char set used in the file. But if for some reason you find that the preview doesn't look right, you can click on the dropdown and select a different option. Once the preview looks correct, we can move on to the next step, which is the import settings. Here, you'll define which products to import. You can choose to add new products and update existing products, meaning that any product that is on the CSV but not in your Plytix account will be added, and products in the CSV that already exist in your Plytix account will be updated. Only add new products, meaning that any existing products will be ignored and will not be updated in your Plytix account. Or only update existing products, meaning any SKU not in your Plytix account will be ignored and will not be updated. Here, you define the status for new products. You can choose from draft or complete. Here you define how to import assets. You can choose to skip existing assets or import all assets. Now we recommend skipping existing assets since they're already in your Plytix account, and reprocessing them can significantly slow down the import. And last but not least, you can choose to create a static list from all the imported products. Once you've defined these options, click go to matching. In the matching screen, the first thing you'll see is the file name at the top. Below this, you'll find a status area that indicates how ready your CSV is for import. It'll tell you whether the system has identified an SKU column. This is a required column, so you'll be unable to import products without first identifying this column. How many of the columns in the spreadsheet have been matched to attributes in the system? Now, not all columns need to be matched, but any column that's not matched to an attribute will be ignored by the system, meaning that that information will not be imported into your account. And whether any duplicate columns have been found. You're unable to match more than one column to an attribute. You'll also see a Save Profile and Load Profile button, which I'll explain more about in a bit. Below this, you'll find an overview of the file settings, and to the right of that, the import settings. These are the same settings that we just saw in the previous steps. You can click the Edit button to go back and make any changes. Now, on to the fun part, data matching. This is where you can map the data from your CSV into attributes and relationships in Plytix. Each of these represents one column in your CSV sheet. Up here is the column header as shown on your CSV. If the system recognizes the column header, it'll automatically match it to an existing element, either an attribute or a relationship in Plytix. For example, here we see that the system recognizes my header SKU and automatically matched it to the system attribute SKU. To the right, we have a preview of the data values of that column. Now, if the header in your CSV said stock keeping unit instead of SKU, then the system wouldn't recognize the header and you'd have to match it manually. For example, now this column isn't matched. You can either match it to an existing element or create a new element. Since I know that the SKU is a system attribute, meaning it's a pre-existing attribute in Plytix, I'll choose Match Existing. Since we're matching to an attribute, you'll click on Attribute, search for the name of the attribute you want to match the column to, select it, and click Match. You'll follow the same process when matching a column to a relationship. System attributes are the default attributes of any Plytix account, and they cannot be deleted. However, the only required system attribute is the SKU. The other ones like label or GTIN are optional. I'll include a link below with a list of all the system attributes. Now let's look at a different column. As you may have noticed, you can easily identify columns that haven't been matched yet by the yellow outline. To create a new element in your account, click on Create New. Here you can choose if you want to create a new attribute or a new relationship. To create a new relationship, you would type the name of the relationship and define the direction of the relationship. Check the description for more information on relationship types and how they work. To create a new attribute, define the attribute name here. And if there are any requirements you want your team to be aware of, you can include an attribute description. Next, you'll choose the attribute type you want to use. Attribute types help you define the output of the fields in Plytix. Choosing the right one allows you to filter more effectively and validate data. For example, by choosing an integer type, you'll ensure that no letters or decimal places are accepted, only whole numbers. The attribute I'm creating, called tags, has multiple possible values, so I'll choose a multi-select type. I don't need to type in all the option values here. The system will automatically detect them and create them for me. When I'm ready, I'll click Match. Notice how the outline turned from yellow to gray. This means that the column has been matched. Once a column has been matched, you'll see a set of advanced settings. So let's go through them. Every attribute will have the empty value settings. This will define whether empty values should be ignored or if they should replace the value that exists in your Plytix account. With multi-select and media gallery attribute types, you'll need to define what to do with new values found in your CSV sheet. You can add the new values to the given attribute, or you can overwrite any existing value for that product's attribute with the new value. For example, say you have a product in your account that has two images, and in your CSV, that cell has the URL of a distinct image. You can choose whether the new image URL should replace the two images in that attribute for that product, or be added to the gallery, therefore making that product now have three images. For multi-select and media galleries, you'll also need to define the value separator used in the CSV sheet you're importing. For decimal attributes, you'll need to choose the decimal separator. An example of this in use would be to show the price in different regions. For example, in the United States, the standard decimal separator is a period, while in Spain, the standard decimal separator is a comma. For the date attribute, you'll need to define how the date is formatted. For example, does the month come first or the date? Are you using two or four digits to show the year? If you click on the question mark here, you can see how to configure the date. With Boolean attributes, you'll need to define which text represents true and which represents false in your CSV. Maybe you're using yes or no. These are case sensitive. Once you've matched all the columns you want to import into your Plytix account, you can have the system remember all the columns that you've matched and the settings chosen for each attribute. This is really useful when the CSV sheet that you're importing follows a format that you'll be importing often into your Plytix account, so that the next time that you import a CSV with the same column format, you can load the profile and the system will apply the settings that you saved. To do this, let's scroll up and click on Save Profile. When saving an import profile, you can choose to create a new profile or update an existing one. Once you're ready, you can go ahead and start your import. The time it takes for your import to complete depends on how many products, assets, relationships, and attributes you're importing. But don't worry, you can leave this page and the system will email you once the import is completed. You'll also see a notification here. You can continue to use your Plytix PIM as normal while your products are uploading. You can also begin a new import matching, which will be queued up once the import in progress is complete. You can create an import feed, which I'll show you how to do in the next video. You can manage import profiles, view a log of past and current imports, and if you see the importing section here, you can check the progress of your current import. I hope you find this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to reach out to us. If you're a Plytix user, you can email your customer success agent or reach out to us by chat at plytix.com.